You are watching For the Greater Good.
Hello guys, I hope you all are doing well. We are back with another video. But this video will be quite different from the rest of our videos because in this one, we'll be discussing and reviewing some books with you on a software that we made using Kiwi, a library of Python. And we'll also teach you how to make this software. So this is how the user interface looks like, and this software basically is a book review system, or more or less like an IMDb for books. So I'll first discuss some of my favorite books with you. Well, I'm a sci-fi fan, so I think you might have guessed by now, I'm a fan of Harry Potter. So we go to Harry Potter, and my favorite Harry Potter book will be Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. So I think we might have a lot of Potterheads here, so I'm pretty excited for this. So this is how the UI looks like, and it contains the plot summary along with the author, quotes and some reviews. We can also add our own review like I love Harry Potter and summary. We can also add our own reviews. Along with that, we can read a plot summary and the quotes from a book. We have many other Harry Potter books here. Also, after Harry Potter, my second favorite might be Hunger Games. Yeah, it definitely is Hunger Games, because, well, you all know that the story and the suspense of Hunger Games is something else. And my favorite Hunger Games book will be Catching Fire. I think most of the people out there love Catching Fire. I personally believe that the movies were not at par with the novel, because Catching Fire was something extraordinary. I don't know if you guys think the same, so same too, but this is what I believe. Okay, now moving ahead, my third favorite book is Da Vinci Code. Okay, the Da Vinci Code is basically a series of novels by Dan Brown, which follows a cryptographer, or you can say a historian, or a symbologist. Symbologist is a better word. That's a symbologist named Robert Langdon, and there are quite some novels in this Robert Langdon series, and they all follow the symbologist as he travels around the world solving different mysteries related to symbology, history. In fact, there's even Illuminati in one of the novels. I think that was Angels and Demons. Okay, talking about the Da Vinci Code, the Da Vinci Code deals with the underground old societies of America. It's a really interesting novel, and its core concept is quite different from the other novels. And the main thing is, but you have to keep in mind that this is a fictitious novel, that nothing in this book is accurate. Okay, a lot of things are accurate, but at the end it is a fictitious novel. Okay, so my third favorite book might be Maze Runner series, and just like the Hunger Games series, I believe the Maze Runner series was spoiled by the movies. My favorite Maze Runner part would be Maze Runner 1. I think everyone loved this one, and every sci-fi fan must read the Maze Runner once. Okay, now we should move to other sections. Horror section. Well, I am not a fan of horror at all. I can't even watch horror movies. So, but there we have some reviews on horror movies, so we can check them out. Like Rosemary's Baby, we have Dracula, the original Dracula. So we can add a number of different books in here through coding. Okay, when we move to thriller, well, you can see Shutter Island. I think everyone here has seen Shutter Island. But do you know that Shutter Island is originally a novel and the movie was an adaptation and a really good one. And we have here Jaws. I think everyone has seen Jaws. Jaws was a blockbuster. And 13 Reasons Why. Yeah, I have read 13 Reasons Why and it was a really good novel. But I believe the series was just average, and season 1 was average, but season 2 and 3 were below par. Let's move to another genre. We have children's novels here, and well, I personally love The Little Prince. I don't know about you guys, if you have read it or if you have seen the movie. It's an amazing novel. And the symbolic representation in the novel is just amazing. And I believe this novel shouldn't even be in the children's section. It's something that everyone should read. Okay, then we have classics, and a lot of people like to read classics. Well, not me, but a lot of people do. To Kill a Mockingbird is a really famous one. But I couldn't even finish it, but a lot of people love it. So that was it. And now let's see its code. Okay, so this software was made using the Kiwi library in Python. Okay, so you will have to install Kiwi, and you can install Kiwi by looking up for its documentation on Google, and it shows a complete procedure of how you can install Kiwi. If you still have any problem while installing Kiwi, you can comment down and we will try to fix your problem. So we have to import Kiwi and its different libraries, and what we have to do, we have to make a Python file. Along with that, we have to make a .kv file. A .kv file, if you are using an IDE like PyCharm, you can just make a simple file and make a .kv and it will make a kv file. But if you are using the simple Python IDE, then you can make the .kv file on Notepad, and you have to save it together with the py file. They both should be in the same place. Okay, if we see what's in the code, well, you can see there's a class for main window and it inherits from screen, and then there's a sci-fi window, there's HP window, there are all sort of windows which are children of screen. So what we are doing in the Python code is that we have to just create a class for every window that we have. For example, this main window is this window. Then when I click on sci-fi, I go to the sci-fi window, which is underneath it. So we just have to create a class. In the Python file, we just have to create a class which inherits from screen and writes pass. That's it. That will create our window. So we have created a lot of windows. As you can see, there are a lot of books, so there is a different window for every one. And we can move down, and then we have to create a window manager. The window manager will be managing all the screens, which will inherit from screen manager, and it will manage all the screens in the software. And then we have created an image button, and we just have to run it at night. There's nothing complicated about. So the main thing, the main window, the main software, the main user interface is made in the KV file. So what we are doing in the KV file, we have to write window manager, which was inheriting from screen manager, and then we have to write down every window that we made. What are the windows? These windows that we made that are the children of screen. So we have to name every window along with a colon. So now we will start with developing each window, one window at a time. So we have, when we start making the main window, we can give it a name so that we can reference it here and there. Then we have to choose a layout for our window. You can learn there are a number of layouts like float layout, relative layout, and other layouts. So we have to create a button, like I have created an image button. Then we have to put a label, then we can put another label, then we create different buttons, just like this. The button has text sci-fi and we have the button here. So in the .kv file, we are designing everything that will appear in our software, in our application. We can put buttons, we can put labels, we can put text, we can put wallpapers, we can put backgrounds, we can put anything and everything we want. So we just have to define the attributes of each, like the attributes for button, like the attributes for labels, and we just have to define everything inside a window. So that's what we have to do. We have to design each window separately, and I guess that's it. That it's really simple. I hope you all guys can do it. And if you like the video, do not forget to like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.